So when it comes to the history of Superman, you've probably seen like imagery of Superman that kind of parallels the idea that he might be like a Christ-like figure. Example, like that Smallville commercial where he's like on the cross, or like the All-Star Superman cover where he's got like light all around him, or even when in the comic, in the death of Superman, when he dies and Lois Lane is holding him in her arms, it reminds you a little bit of like the Michelangelo sculpture. I think it's called like Piadana or Piadina or something like that, where Mary is holding Jesus after they brought him off the cross. Even if within the story context, you kind of see it a little bit like Superman's like the super powerful being who comes out of the sky, and you know, he's here to be a savior to people. I guess the question is like, so is Superman Jesus? Well, it depends on who you ask. And this week in our class, we talked about a gentleman named Joseph Campbell. We spent a pretty good deal talking about him. He was an author, and so a little background on him. He was raised as a Roman Catholic, and he was always looking for parallels in the stories. And he wrote this book called The Hero with a Thousand Faces, which was printed in 1949, which I'm kind of interested in reading now. And he says that there's a lot of parallels in the hero. Like the hero, he says, is always the same in every story, he says, because he's approaching religion not as a position where of theology, or you know, hey, is this really true, or religious and stuff. He's approaching it more like stories, and I can see how that some people might be able to find that offensive, because like, oh, he's saying that it's a myth or it's a story, the story of Jesus. But I don't really necessarily see it like that. I myself come from a Roman Catholic background. I consider myself Christian, and I don't really consider this offensive. I feel like it's an exploration of those ideas of the story structures, and you're kind of approaching it from a literature form. Basically what he's saying is that every story is the same. First, he was finding like parallels between like Christian stories. You can find it in other stories, like in the story of Buddha, the story of Muhammad, and you can find it in other like myths and legends and stuff like that. So for him, it was kind of like, what is it that, you know, why is this it always seems to be like the same hero? So he went down and he kind of went down the list, and he was like trying to show the similarities between these certain stories. And some of the ones he talked about was like, one, it was like one of the things he talked about was the ordinary world. He's saying that the hero comes from an ordinary world. He is not really anybody special, right? And if you can see it, you can see it from heroes like Superman. He comes from Kansas, you know, it's like he's a nobody. If you see it with people like Harry Potter, like he's just a kid living in a closet underneath the stairs, you know, he's really a nobody. Frodo, you know, those are some of the ideas. Dorothy from Kansas. These are all heroes from like pretty boring everyday situations. They're not necessarily like extravagant, and that's one common thing that you would have with a lot of these stories with heroes. Another thing that he would say is that there was always a call for adventure. Like there's always something that's pulling that hero towards something else, right? Like it's kind of like the owl in Harry Potter that says, Harry, you got to go to that school, stuff like that. And it's things that set things in motion, right? Another example would be like Luke Skywalker, when Obi-Wan Kenobi shows up, and then, you know, this desert planet's really nothing really, there's nothing really cool about this planet. And Obi Kenobi's like, hey, you got to come with me. You know, there's that call to adventure. And you always get that reluctant hero. He says that's another common thing, is that the hero's always reluctant. Like he's not chasing after the power. He's not going after it. And then this says that's why, you know, it makes a hero, because he is reluctant to assume that responsibility. Like going right back to Luke Skywalker didn't want that. He's like, oh, it's not me, I'm not the one, you know, whatever like that. There's always like some kind of mentorship in his stories. He says that they go through tests, and then they have allies, like a supporting cast, and then they also have enemies. So the hero has to overcome like some of these things. Like even if you go back into mythology, with like Greek mythology, with Jason and what he had to go through in the Odyssey, and also some of the things that, you know, Hercules and his labors and stuff like that, they all go through tests. I think there's, I forget how many there are, but there's quite a bit. There's about 15 or 16 things that he kind of says, oh, these are some of the common things that are found in all stories. And I think that that's kind of what he was trying to highlight with like Superman, that Superman fits that archetype of the hero who comes from like these humble beginnings, nothing. He gets a call to adventure, and then you kind of find out that yes, he's from an ordinary setting, but he's also something about him is very special. I don't know if I completely agree. I think I agree with this to a certain extent. I think there's heroes that you would feel like it's the underdog. I really like the story of Rocky, which is like very similar. You got a guy who's kind of unassuming. He's pretty much a nobody boxer, washed up, and then he becomes the world champion. I want to read this book so I can understand it a little bit more. I can see a little bit of what he's trying to say, but a lot of it I'm like not completely buying it, because I think it's different now with comic books, because you have a bunch of heroes, but you also have a bunch of different kinds of heroes. Like Batman, I would feel like wouldn't fit in this archetype. I don't think Bruce Wayne comes from like humble beginnings. Like, he's the freaking son of the billionaire, the biggest billionaires in Gotham City. So there's like a little bit of difference there. I think Batman feels a different need within the superhero mythology. And another thing that we talked about that I thought was pretty interesting was the popularity of Superman over the years. When he first came out, it was during the war years, or a little bit right before the war, but war was on everybody's mind. And I think it was at this time, if you kind of put yourself in the mindset of those people back then, that the Nazis or the German army seemed very powerful at that time. Hitler seemed unstoppable. Like, they took over France. So defeat was an absolute possibility, and I think people feared that as well. I think even though when the Russians, when they were invaded and they made their stand at Stalingrad, they were like, we need to put a stop to that. Like, yeah, we might get taken over and occupied like the way France is. So there was a possibility that Hitler might win, and I think it was that togetherness that people kind of appealed to, that being that was like a superhero, that Christ-like figure, the goodness hero, the hero that always does the right decision and it's all powerful and all that. But you kind of see that popularity of Superman kind of went down over the years, and it goes up and then it goes down. And what was interesting, I think, is that we're just kind of seeing it with the parallel, especially with American mentality, is that when the nation's kind of down in the dumps is when Superman's like the most popular. Or not down in the dumps, but like when the country's going through a serious crisis that unites people, is usually that time that, you know, Superman kind of elevates, right? And so like you see kind of like a resurgence of the popularity of Superman around 2001, when September 11th happened. And I think it was a lot of that because heroic people or heroic ideals came to the forefront of America, as far as like when it came to September 11 and the way people saw first responders and nurses and all those people that went through things in September 11. On September 11, there was a lot of heroes, and some of them were not first responders. Some of them were just ordinary people doing extraordinary things just to help other people that they didn't even know. Like, these people were very heroic on that very tragic day. And it was around that time where, you know, Smallville really took off, because I think Superman kind of really struck a chord with that heroic figure within pop culture and within the mentality of people. So I think that's interesting, right? I think that's very interesting. As far as like, I think that that's kind of interesting to see how Superman kind of goes through that, especially because Superman is so ingrained into American culture. Like, Superman is like American as American get, right? He's a comic book hero, which is authentically American, like apple pie. You know, it's like Creedence Clearwater Revival. You know, it's Superman, the big blue Boy Scout. And while I'm still more of a Batman guy, right? Because I like Batman a little bit more. Oh, he's a little bit more hardened and stuff like that, and he's also more of an underdog. I think with going through this, I've really learned to respect Superman. I feel like I see Superman and I see what he means to people in the mentality of American people. And I see what he means, and I have grown a lot of respect for it. And now this also makes me excited for the James Gunn movie that's going to be coming out, that's going to be based on All-American Superman. And I remember some of the interviews or some of the stuff that he was talking about, some of his ideas for Superman as this heroic figure and how he used his dad. He's like, his dad was one of his most, you know, biggest heroes in James Gunn's world, is I think is what he was trying to say. And I kind of like the ideas of him trying to bring that idea of Superman back, that fresh cut, clean cut, all American, very humble, or just wants to do a good deed kind of boy, kind of good deed kind of Boy Scout. And I truly do think that with James Gunn, that the DC universe is going to start with Superman. So I think with James Gunn, if you're going to have a successful DC universe, I think it's going to have to start the same way that it started with the comics, with a good superhero, with a good Superman that is a symbol of hope, right? And that's your big superhero, and then from there on you can just unravel the rest of the world. I think next we're going to be talking, still going to be talking about a little bit of Superman, but then we're going to start getting into Wonder Woman and women in comics, and I'm pretty excited about that because I do like Diana Prince, and I have read some of those old comics, and I've read some of her runs, so I've kind of familiar with her evolution through time, but I'm kind of very excited to keep adding to that package of knowledge. So anyways, thank you guys. You guys let me know what your opinions are on this whole subject of like Christianity and Superman, and what are your thoughts on that? Anyways, I'll see you guys on the next one, okay? Take care, peace.